Good morning. Welcome back to the course of Power Quality. I am Dr. Prema from BMS College, Bangalore. So we are here with the third module of the course Power Quality. And in the last six lectures, we have seen the following topics in the third module. Third module is with fundamentals of harmonics. And we saw harmonic distortion, the definition of harmonics in the power system, then the difference between voltage and current distortion, and difference between harmonics and transients. And we saw the harmonic indices, such as total harmonic distortion and total demand distortion. Then we also saw the main harmonic sources, which are produced by commercial loads and industrial loads. And then we saw the effect of harmonic distortion in the various components of power system. We also saw the concept of interharmonics, which is a non-integer multiple of fundamental frequency. So in the last six lectures, we have covered almost all the topics in the syllabus. Today is the seventh lecture, and today we are going to see some real case studies which happens in the industry, and we are going to see what is the actual system, and then we will see what exactly is the problem in the system. We will see what causes that problem in the system. So we are going to see three case studies today, followed by a short quiz in the topics of the third module. Let us go to the case studies. So these are the case studies and these are the technical problems which are experienced in the industry. So let us take the case one. And here the type of industry is the paperboard manufacturing industry. And the installation descriptions are follows. Primary power source is a grid supply with 33 kV, and the distribution voltage coming to the industry is 440 volt, and an induction motor with a capacity of 800 HP is connected as the load in the industry. So this is the description of the industry. So we are going to see what is going to happen in this industry, paperboard manufacturing industry. Now here, in that particular industry, as I told, we have an induction motor with 800 HP capacity, and there are no nonlinear loads present in the system. So no nonlinear loads or any other power converters are installed in the system. But there is one capacitor bank of a capacity 300 kVAR. It's a three-phase capacitor bank with a voltage of 440. And this is installed for the power factor correction. And some capacitors are connected across the motor terminals, and the remaining are used as central compensation. So there is a power factor correction capacitor bank. Apart from that, anyway, capacitor banks are not nonlinear loads. There are no nonlinear loads present in the system. What is present is only the capacitor banks, which are used for power factor correction. Now, what exactly was the problem experienced in the industry? Yeah, there was a frequent failure of capacitors. So ideally speaking, the industry, when viewed from the industry, there are no nonlinear loads. So there is no reason for the failure of capacitors. Now, what causes the failure of capacitors? Let us see the analysis of that. The system voltage was around 435 to 440 volts. And the capacitors are installed. They are subjected to severe intermittent overloading. So capacitor was getting overloaded. And what could be the reason for that? There is no reason, because it is only an induction motor which is running. But very often, the capacitor was found to be overloaded. And what kind of overload, or what amount of overload? So the capacitor was rated for 25 kVAR and 440 volt, and the rated current of the capacitor was 90 to 120 ampere. The rated current was only 33 ampere, but at certain times the current drawn by the capacitors was found to be 90 to 120 ampere, which is around 250% overload. The rated capacitor current is only 33 ampere, but the capacitor was drawing a current of sometimes up to 120 ampere. This was a heavy overload, around 250% of overload, and this abnormal overloading resulted in capacitor failure. And this used to happen very frequently. So the industry people were wondering what could be the reason for the capacitor failure, because from their part there is no reason for overload because there are no nonlinear loads present. So what could be the actual reason? The following observations were made on the 33 kV grid. So this industry is connected to a 33 kV grid, and with that industry there is only one more industry which are connected to that particular portion. That there are only two industries. One is this industry, and another one was a steel rolling mill. Apart from the paper rolling industry, paper board industry, which is under consideration, there was one more industry which is connected to that 33 kV line, which was a steel rolling mill. And the distance between these two plants, the paper board industry and the steel rolling mill, was around 10 kilometers. And this steel rolling mill had a very frequency induction furnace. So we have seen in the past few lectures that induction furnace can cause very heavy overloading and very heavy distortion. We have seen some waveforms also and how heavy the overloading is. So, but that is the displaced around 10 kilometers away from this particular industry. So there was no reason to think that is causing a failure of the capacitor bank, which is installed in the paper board. So it was observed that whenever there is the high frequency induction furnace is installed in the steel mill is getting operated, at that time there is a heavy harmonic distortion on the grid, and which was affecting the capacitor, and the capacitor was getting overloaded. So whenever the induction furnace was working, the capacitor was getting overloaded. This was the observation made. So the conclusion, the use of conventional capacitors in the network where the harmonic distortion at the grid is abnormally high results in the following condition. The capacitors get overloaded. That could be because of the series resonance happening, because there's a distortion in the voltage because of the steel rolling mill, because of the induction furnace in the steel rolling mill. So the voltage is distorted. When the voltage is distorted, there are harmonic present in the system. So when that the resonant frequency of the capacitance along with the inductance of the line and the distribution transformers, when that particular frequency is matching with any of these harmonic frequencies, then we have the problem of resonance, right? So it could be possible that series resonant condition happened, and because of that, the capacitors was getting overloaded, and the capacitors were failing frequently. And the low voltage bus experienced increasing harmonic distortion, and the inability for the customer to maintain desired power factor. So power factor, because capacitors were failing, the power factor was not up to the mark. And of course, there are financial losses incurred by the customer. So these are the main problems due to this. So the industry as such didn't have any nonlinear load, but because of a neighboring industry which had a induction furnace, the capacitor bank in the present this particular industry was failing, and due to that there was heavy overload on the LV bus also. So this is the first case. Now let us go to the second case, where the industry is a cement industry, and the installation was from a 220 kV grid, and the distribution voltage was 6.6 kV and 440 volt. So this is the system description. And then there was a power factor correction here also. So there was a low voltage power factor correction on the 440 volt bus around 2000 kVAr power factor correction panels with the conventional capacitors were installed. And this particular capacitance was distributed on several points on the distribution transformer. So this is the description of the system. The industry is a cement industry. And what was the problem experienced at the low voltage bus? The malfunction of 350 kV 440 volt DC drive used for the skin motor. So in cement industries, we have skin motor, which basically has a DC drive. So in DC drive, as we have seen earlier, It is to control the speed of the DC motor, which is there, which is the Kin motor basically. And then we have power converters there. So in that Kin motor, there is a power converter, which is a nonlinear load. And what was the problem experience? The DC drive used for Kin motor installed at the cement plant substation, the capacitors are connected in the network. So we have a nonlinear load and we have a capacitor bank connected in the network. So what happens there? The cement plant substation was fed by a 1600 kVA, 6.6 to 440 volt transformer. And there was a constant nonlinear loading, which was exceeded by around 22%. This conventional capacitor is also connected. The rating of the capacitors is 475 kVAR. And there are other loads such as compressors, pumps. They are all linear loads, but they are existing in the system. And the DC drive or the Kin motor was malfunctioning. And it was related to a specific combination of capacitance. So this capacitor bank, there are some part of the capacitor bank which are connected at times. So for a specific combination or specific value of this capacitor bank, there was a malfunction detected in the DC drive. That was the problem. Now coming to the conclusion. So what's the conclusion? You have a conventional capacitor bank, which is used for power factor correction. And then you have a DC drive. So here, very clearly, we have a nonlinear load which is connected. And because of that, there was voltage distortion. And again, because of that, this capacitor bank also was getting affected. So here, the malfunctioning of the DC drive was the problem due to the combination of the particular combination of capacitance for the power factor improvement and the nonlinear load. So this is the second case. Now we have one more case which is considered. This is about a steel rolling mill. So here the power source is again from a grid of 33 kV and the distribution voltage was 440. And there are three distribution transformers with the plant, two 200 kVA and one 100 kVA distribution transformer. So there are three distribution transformers in the system. And there is an induction motor of 1000 HP and there's a DC drive of 500 HP. So these are the loads connected to the system. So we have the power is obtained from a 33 kV grid with a distribution voltage of 440 volt. And there are three distribution transformers, two of 2000 kVA and one of 1000 kVA. And there are two motors. One is an induction motor and one is a DC drive. So these are the loads connected to the system. This is the system. And this is a schematic diagram of the system. You can see that there are distribution transformers. There are three distribution transformers. And then there are two motors. One is a 100 HP induction motor. One is a 500 HP DC motor. And along with that, you have a 900 kVAR capacitor. So that is for the power factor correction. And we have a capacitor bank there. So the main grid is 330 kV and distribution is 440 volt bus. So this is the schematic. Now what is the problem experienced here? The failure of capacitors were observed. Now that coming to the analysis, the result of the analysis is that there is a capacitor bank and it was drawing 65, the rated value of the capacitance was 65 ampere, but at times the capacitor was drawing a current of 200 ampere. This was resulting after 300% overloading of the capacitor. So this was the main reason for the failure of capacitor. And the total harmonic distortion was also observed to be 25%, which was very high, higher than the accepted level of the THD. So this was the main problem. And the conclusion is the capacitors are getting overloaded due to parallel resonance because you have the transformers and then we have the induction motor and we have the DC drive and the capacitor. they are all coming in parallel, and we have the problem of parallel resonance here, due to which the capacitors were failing very frequently. And again here, the customer was not able to maintain the enough power factor, and again there is a financial loss for the customer. So these are the main problems. So what can we understand from this is that even though there are capacitor banks which are used for power factor correction, improvement of power factor, because of the presence of nonlinear loads which are there in the adjacent industries or in that industry itself, or due to anywhere in that particular line, there can be problems due to harmonics. There can be voltage distortion due to which there will be harmonics present, and this can cause the capacitor failure. So most of the time, the industry people, the customers may not know what exactly is the problem. But by analyzing, we need to analyze what are the real causes for this. There could be some nonlinear load which is causing a distortion. Then the mitigation steps need to be taken by using some active filters for mitigating this harmonic. So this is all about the third unit of the harmonics. Now we are going to see some quiz questions which can enforce your understanding about this particular module. So the first question is, eighth harmonic is negative sequence harmonic. Is this statement true or false? So we have seen how to determine the phase sequence of a of a harmonic component or of a waveform. So in that we have seen that if you have the number, harmonic number, then you divide by 3, and if the remainder is 1, then it is positive sequence. If the remainder is 2, then it is a negative sequence. And if the remainder is 0, or if the number is divisible by 3, then it will be a zero sequence component. So this is, you should remember that. Now if you analyze this, you will know the answer. So we have the harmonic number 8 here. If you divide by 3, you have 6 and the remainder 3, remainder 2, right? So it is obviously a negative sequence, and the statement is true. So the answer is option A. Now, the next question, what is the phase sequence of 12th harmonic? Again, the same similar question we have. So you have to divide the particular harmonic number by 3, and if the remainder is 1, then we have positive sequence. If remainder is 2, then negative, and remainder is 0, then it's a zero sequence. So here the number is 12, and 12 is divisible by 3, so obviously it has to be a zero sequence component. So the answer is B. Then we have next question. The RMS value of the third harmonic component in a nonlinear load is 20 ampere. The RMS value of fifth harmonic component is 15 ampere. The RMS value of fundamental is 60 ampere. Then the individual third harmonic distortion. Read the question carefully. We have a harmonic current where there are two components given, third harmonic and fifth harmonic. The RMS values are given. Third harmonic RMS is 20 ampere, fifth harmonic RMS is 15 ampere, and the fundamental current has an RMS value of 60 ampere. Now what is to be found out? We need to find the individual third harmonic distortion. Remember, it is not THD we have to find out. It is the individual harmonic component of the third harmonic. So how do we do that? Again, any distortion is measured with respect to the fundamental quantity. If you have to measure the third distortion due to the third harmonic, then the RMS value of third harmonic should be divided by the RMS value of fundamental quantity. So how do we do it here? We need to find the third harmonic distortion, which will be RMS value of third harmonic, which is 20 ampere, to the RMS value of fundamental, which is 16 ampere. So we have 20 divided by 60. When we represent it as a percentage, it is 1 by 3.33. And as a percentage, it is 33.3. So the answer is C. So if you have to find out the individual harmonic distortion of any component, you should have the RMS value of that component and the fundamental. By taking the ratio of that particular RMS value to the fundamental will give you the harmonic distortion for that particular harmonic level. So that is what we get from this question. Now in the next question, here we are going to find the total harmonic distortion. So the question is, what is the total harmonic distortion of a voltage waveform with fundamental harmonic voltage of 114 volt, third harmonic frequency voltage of 4 volts, fifth harmonic voltage of 2 volts, seventh harmonic voltage of 1.5 volt and ninth of 1 volt. So we have several harmonic components given. We have all odd harmonics are there. We have third, fifth, seventh and ninth harmonic. Also the fundamental value is given. So all these RMS values are given. We need to find out the THD. Please try to do that. So the formula for finding out THD is square root of summation of all the RMS values of all the harmonic present in the system to the fundamental frequency. So when you're taking the RMS value, you will not take the fundamental. You will eliminate the fundamental. The formula is square root of summation m h greater than 1 to h maximum mth square divided by m1. That is the formula. That means we have to take the RMS value of all the harmonics present to the fundamental voltage. So if you do that, let us come to the answer. So here we have the THD formula, square root of summation h greater than 1 to h max m square by m1. So m square, we have 4 volt, 2 volt, 1.5 volt and 1 volt. Take the square of all those. So we have square root of 4 square plus 2 square plus 1.5 square plus 1 square, the whole divided by the fundamental value, which is 114. So when you calculate this, we get 4.23%. So the answer is A. So I hope now you got the idea of calculating THD. If you want to find out total harmonic distortion of THD, then you have to take whatever available harmonic components, take the square of all those values and divide it by the fundamental RMS voltage, then you get the THD. If you want to find out individual, you have to take only that particular harmonic component and divide it by the fundamental. So this is how we calculate the distortion of any frequency component. I hope that is clear to you now. Now let us go to the fifth question. The question is, if the system has a fundamental frequency of 50 Hz and is balanced with all parameters point of view, then which of the following harmonic frequency does not get produced? So here the fundamental frequency is 50 Hz and then the harmonic components given here in the option are 100 Hz, 150 Hz, 250 Hz and 450 Hz. So if you calculate the harmonic number of all these quantities, then 100 Hz is second harmonic, 150 Hz is third harmonic, 250 is sixth and 450 is seventh. So which one is not supposed to be produced in a balanced system? So we have already discussed this factor that in a balanced system, most of the power system will have a symmetrical waveform, a waveform which is symmetric with respect to the x-axis. What does that mean? It will have equal positive and negative cycle. Then even though it is distorted, if it is symmetric with respect to x-axis, then we have seen that we won't have any even harmonics present in the system. So that principle has to be applied to this question. So here we have second harmonic, third, fifth and seventh are given. So apart from second harmonics, all are odd number of harmonics which could be present. which is possible to be present in the system. So, but if the system is balanced, you your waveform will be symmetric with respect to x-axis, and because of that, you will not have even harmonic component. So the harmonic frequency which does not get produced is 100 hertz, and the answer is option A. With this, we have come to the end of our third module. I hope you enjoyed all the videos. I hope you understood the concept of harmonics and all the concepts what we discussed in the past 6 lectures. And today we have also discussed some of the real-time case studies, which would be helpful for you to analyze what exactly are the problems created by harmonics. So thank you very much for listening to all the videos. Now we will be back with the 4th module in the next lecture. Next lecture, we will start with the 4th module. Thank you. Thank you very much.